What's up, sons? It's Blind Run once again with Son of a Tech, and today we have the long-awaited XFX RX 480 Black Edition. So this is pretty much the limit for the reference style cards that AMD supplied, and XFX has taken it as far as it can go. Stick around to find out more. The XFX RX 480 Black Edition features a reference design cooler with a little bit of flair. While this may be disappointing to some looking for custom cooler designs, it has allowed XFX to push the design to its limits. To give the card a more premium feel, XFX has equipped the card with a simplistic yet functional backplate, with a cutout for the GPU core similar to that you've seen on higher-end Fiji chips. Display adapters include three DisplayPort 1.4 ports and a single HDMI 2.0B port. Next we have the 6-pin power adapter, sporting a massive 6+1 power phase, delivering a peak power output of 165 watts, which is a very high limit for a single 6-pin adapter. For comparison, the GTX 1080 has a single 8-pin power adapter with a 5+1 power phase. Under the hood, the card sports a 1326 MHz boost clock, which is 42 MHz over the core edition or reference design. The boost clock communicates over a 256-bit bus with 8 GB of GDDR5 at a standard 8000 MHz effective clock. This particular card absolutely loves being overclocked. The core clock hit a peak overclock of 1405 MHz. The memory overclocked surprisingly well too, with an additional 200 MHz. This translated into frame rate increases across the board. For enthusiastic overclockers, this graphics card is a dream come true. The reference cooler is the shortcoming for the card. The design is loud when at the 100% mark that is required when overclocked. If you leave the default fan profiles, the card will thermothrottle and, in some cases, crash. And even at 100%, the card hits high temperatures in the 90 degrees Celsius range. While you're talking about a card that's quite a few hundred dollars more than the RX 480, we are still going to compare with the MSI GTX 1080 Gaming X Edition, as I'm changing around some of my benchmarks and moving all towards DirectX 12 and Vulkan, as that's the future of gaming, and that's probably what we're going to want to be buying for. So, to get things started, we have Rise of the Tomb Raider at max settings with SMAA x4, and the Radeon RX 480 Black Edition hit a total of 38.62 frames per second. So there is some room for improvement at 1080p still, and that's why I'm still doing all of my tests in 1080p. Until I'm hitting good frame rates at 144 to match the refresh rate of my panel, I don't see a need to bump up into any other new resolution yet. Next we have Forza Motorsport 6 Apex, which is in beta, but it does offer a lot of cool options for graphics, and I was super surprised. It also supports something for UWP that's new, that's like a dynamic graphics quality adjustment, and I haven't had a chance to really sit down and play with that. I'm going to try to do that and take a look at make a video over for you guys explaining what it's changing, why it's changing it, and how that helps improve your gameplay experience. But at settings fully maxed out, which is what we went ahead and did, and we turned it and locked it, settings maxed out, the Radeon RX 480 Black Edition hit a huge respectable 83.4 frames per second, which is only 20 frames short of the 1080. In 3DMark TimeSpy Graphics Test 1, we hit a frame rate of 46.9 frames per second, and in 3DMark TimeSpy Graphics Test 2, we hit a total of 36.4 frames per second. In Doom, we saw something interesting here, and I'll probably try to include this in the graph as well if I get some time. On ultra settings at 1080p, in Vulkan, of course, because remember, we're not using any old APIs anymore, so all of these games are Vulkan or DirectX 12. We hit a massive 150 frames per second. That's everything maxed out, and that actually beats out the Radeon Pro Duo, which we know was actually only running one GPU at the time, but that one GPU that it was running was the Fury, which is a significantly more expensive GPU, and so even within the AMD lineup, this RX 480 is making some waves. In the Talos Principle, which is actually a Vulkan second game, it is in beta. The API is in beta. The Talos Principle is not. But we hit a total of 59.2 frames per second fully maxed out. It does fall super, super short of the GTX 1080, which was able to hit 171.6 frames per second. Next, we have Gears of War Ultimate Edition with 4K textures maxed out, and we hit a very respectable 130 frames per second in gauge async. Am I right? That's only 20 frames short of the GTX 1080. Next, we have Hitman, which of course is an AMD game, and in DirectX 12, it hit 83 frames per second, which is respectable. And in Total War Warhammer, with Ultra SMAA times 8, we hit a total of 34.1 frames per second. In conclusion, if you're on a budget and enjoy tinkering with overclocking, this card is right up your alley. However, while FPS numbers are astronomically high for the price point in some games, AMD is yet to keep this consistent across all games. For PC gaming enthusiasts looking to just throw a GPU in and game without setting configurations, you may want to look into something that performs more predictably. I love the overclocking unicorn I got in this card, and I'm curious what numbers you guys are getting. Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, guys, and until next time, I'll see you next Tuesday.